Praise be Jesus Christ, forever and ever. Amen. Good morning. Welcome to all who have gathered here on this, the Lord's Day, to celebrate the Holy Eucharist. In a special way, we extend a warm welcome to all who are worshiping with us at Our Lady of the Scapular Parish for the first time and to any guests present. Please take a moment now before Mass begins to turn off or silence all cell phones. Today is the fifth Sunday of Easter. The celebrant of this Mass will be our pastor, Father Mark Borkowski. As we prepare to joyfully worship the Lord, we ask all to stand and join in singing our opening hymn, Rejoice, O Mary, Heavenly Queen, found on the printed Mass program.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly beseech the Lord our God to bless this water he has created, which will be sprinkled on us as a memorial of our baptism. May he help us by his grace to remain faithful to the Spirit we have received. Lord our God, in your mercy, be present to your people's prayers, and for us who recall the wondrous work of our creation and the still greater work of our redemption, graciously bless this water. For you created water to make the fields fruitful and to refresh and cleanse our bodies. You also made water the instrument of your mercy, for through water you freed your people from slavery and quenched their thirst in the desert. Through water, the prophets proclaimed the new covenant you were to enter upon with the human race. And last of all, through water which Christ made holy in the Jordan, you have renewed our corrupted nature in the bath of regeneration. Therefore, may this water be for us a memorial of the baptism we have received, and grant that we may share in the gladness of our brothers and sisters who at Easter have received their baptism through Christ our Lord. I saw water
coming from the temple, from the right side.
May Almighty God cleanse us of our sins, and through the celebration of this Eucharist, make us worthy to share at the table of his kingdom. Amen. Glory to God in the highest,
and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, constantly accomplish the paschal mystery within us, that those you are pleased to make new in holy baptism may, under your protective care, bear much fruit and come to the joys of life eternal, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When Saul arrived in Jerusalem, he tried to join the disciples, but they were all afraid of him, not believing that he was a disciple. Then Barnabas took charge of him and brought him to the apostles, and he reported to them how he had seen the Lord and that he had spoken to him, and how in Damascus he had spoken out boldly in the name of Jesus. He moved about freely with them in Jerusalem and spoke out boldly in the name of the Lord. He also spoke and debated with the Hellenists, but they tried to kill him. And when the brothers learned of this, they took him down to Caesarea and sent him on his way to Tarsus. The church throughout all Judea, Galilee, and Samaria was at peace. It was being built up and walked in the fear of the Lord, and with the consolation of the Holy Spirit, it grew in numbers. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. I will praise you, Lord, in the assembly of your people.
I will fulfill my vows before those who fear the Lord. The lowly shall eat their fill. They who seek the Lord shall praise him.
Will praise you, Lord, in the assembly of your people.
All the ends of the earth shall remember and turn to the Lord. All the families of the nations shall bow down before him. To him alone shall bow down all who sleep in the earth. Before him shall bend all who go down in the dust.
I will praise you, Lord,
in the assembly of your And to him my soul shall live, my descendants shall serve him. Let the coming generation be told of the Lord, that they may proclaim to a people yet to be born the justice he has shown.
I will praise you, Lord,
in the assembly of your people.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Children, let us love not in word or speech, but in deed and truth. Now this is how we shall know that we belong to the truth and reassure our hearts before him in whatever our hearts condemn. For God is greater than our hearts and knows everything. Beloved, if our hearts do not condemn us, we have confidence in God and receive from him whatever we ask, because we keep his commandments and do what pleases him. And his commandment is this: we should believe in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and love one another just as he commanded us. Those who keep his commandments remain in him, and he in them. And the way we know that he remains in us is from the Spirit he gave us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Remain in me as I remain in you, says the Lord. Whoever remains in me will bear much fruit.
Alleluia. Alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine grower. He takes away every branch in me that does not bear fruit, and every one that does, he prunes so that it bears more fruit. You are already pruned because of the word that I spoke to you. Remain in me as I remain in you. Just as a branch cannot bear fruit on its own unless it remains on the vine, so neither can you unless you remain in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. Whoever remains in me and I in him will bear much fruit, because without me you can do nothing. Anyone who does not remain in me will be thrown out like a branch and wither. People will gather them and throw them into a fire, and they will be burned. If you remain in me and my words remain in you, ask for whatever you want and it will be done for you. By this is my Father glorified, that you bear much fruit and become my disciples. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise be Jesus Christ. My dear friends, on this fifth Sunday of Easter, the Lord gives us another image of his resurrected self to contemplate. So if you'll remember, last Sunday Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. And that was easy to understand. It makes good sense. Jesus the shepherd who cares for his sheep, we are his sheep, he takes care of us, he watches over us, he protects us, he feeds us, he does just everything for us. We have nothing to fear if we are his sheep. That imagery made sense. Now this Sunday we have a different imagery, which also makes sense, but perhaps requires a little bit of thought. So the Lord Jesus says, I am the true vine. He is a vine. That's how he calls himself. So for this, you have to think about it for a moment. His imagery is, I'm the living vine, and he is living. That's what we are celebrating during the Easter season, all these Sundays of Easter, and in fact, every Sunday, we are celebrating the fact, we are calling to mind and prayerfully thinking about the fact that the Lord Jesus, who was brutally killed, rose gloriously from the dead, and lives forever, and that he makes eternal life possible for all of us. That's what we celebrate at Easter. So Jesus calls himself, I am the true vine, the living vine. And then he speaks about the branches. So just like we were the sheep, we are the branches. He says, you are the branches. And that makes sense. He is the source of all life. And the branches of a plant go out. They take their life from the plant itself, from the vine, from the core, from the trunk, so to speak. So that is the imagery that our Lord uses to describe the relationship. We get our life from him. And then he goes on to say, remain connected to me. Don't cut yourself off, because, as you know, we're gardening people. This I have come to realize now, down in the Downriver area, people like to grow things here. We're not exactly farmers, we're backyard farmers. And we're all growing things, it seems. You drive around, everybody's, and it, of course, it became even more obvious to me on Thursday, I had to go to Schwartz's, not to buy anything, just to order something. On a weekday, in the rain, the place was packed. Had to fight my way through just to place an order for some rose bushes for the rectory. Because people down here, we want to grow things. We understand the concept of growing. And the concept of these plants that we're putting into the ground, bearing fruit, or maybe bearing, I don't know, tomatoes, cucumbers, that's what I'll be growing. Or beautiful flowers. We understand this concept. We understand it very well that our Lord is using this day. And we know what happens. So our Lord says, remain connected to me. I am the source of all life. Remain connected to me. Do not get yourself disconnected. So we all know how that goes. You're working in your garden and you bring the clip, 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 clip. And I'm sure everybody's experienced it before. You end up, I didn't realize, I didn't want to cut that branch off. Oop, clip, and it's gone. And when something has been clipped off from the plant, that's just the end of it. Even if it was a beautiful flower and you didn't mean to do it, or a branch that had a possibility of a tomato on it, you didn't mean to do it, clip, clip, and it's gone. There's no, you can put it in a vase, but it's dead. Its life is over. Without the source of life, it just doesn't go on. So Jesus cautions us, remain connected to him. All right, that makes good sense. He's the source of life. Without life, you're dead. So how is it that you remain connected to Jesus? That's the question. How do you remain connected to Jesus? And it's just pure good luck that this gospel passage fell on this day, on this weekend, when we had one First Communion yesterday, we have more First Communions today. It's the perfect passage for First Communion Sunday. Because how do you remain connected to the Lord Jesus? You remain connected by going to Mass and receiving Holy Communion. Because through that Holy Communion that we receive, his life comes to us. We become part of him, our connection to him. All the nutrients, like through the plant, all the nutrients come up through the stem. He brings all that we need, every aspect of living. He gives it to us in Holy Communion, because Holy Communion is him himself. He begins to live within us. That's the wonderful thing about this First Communion Day for these children. Soon, for the first time, you'll receive Jesus, and he begins to live in you. And this is the first time, and then there will be the second time, and the third time, and the 25th time, and the 100th time. You know, if you live to be about 80, there'll be the 1,400 times. If you go to Mass on every Sunday, that's how you stay connected. That's how he begins to live in you. And that's what we must do. I mean, this is the primary way of staying connected. That doesn't mean I'm saying, well, you know, you can't stay connected by praying to him. Sure you can. You can't stay connected by being kind to others, doing all kinds of acts of charity, doing all kinds of good things. Certainly, those things are desirable, but without the connection, the main connection, those things are like when you clip off the branch that has a flower on it. It's good for a while, but when it's disconnected from the source of life, eventually it's dead. And that is not what we are wanting. We were created to live forever. And the source of the secret to eternal life is staying connected to the Lord Jesus in Holy Communion. So my dear parishioners and guests who are here present, and children yourselves, when you watch the children go to Holy Communion this day, it's a time to think for a moment about how important this Holy Communion is. How important it is to welcome into your heart, Sunday after Sunday, or for that matter, day after day, because the Mass is offered in this church a lot. To welcome into your heart, as I say, regularly, over and over again. Because every communion that you receive in this life, that's an intimate moment of connecting to the source of all life, to the vine. That's a moment of connecting to the vine through which everything we need to live forever comes to us. And we must never forget that. You can never think to yourself, well, you know, I'm not going to go to church this weekend. I don't really feel like it. Really? You don't feel like it? Do you feel like being clipped off like a flower, destined to die? No. This is the priority for us who are believers, connecting ourselves over and over again so that we become strong branches, strong branches. Right now, these children are just going to be like little branches. But after over and over a life lived with our, then you become such a strong branch that high winds are not going to bother you. All the other dangers to a plant are not going to bother you, because you are strongly connected to the source, to the vine. And may every one of us take that quite seriously and continuously work on connecting ourselves more and more, stronger and stronger, to Jesus, the Good Shepherd, the true vine, and the source of all life. Amen. Now at this point, the fun begins. So I invite the children to bring your candle to the altar and stand where I showed you. Right here. Bring the candle. Take that candle out of the holder carefully. Okay. Here it comes. Dear children, very soon during this Mass, you will go to Holy Communion for the first time and receive the body and blood of the Lord Jesus. First, you need to reject evil and sin and profess your faith. At the time of your birth, your parents and godparents asked of God for you the grace of baptism and committed themselves to bring you up in the faith, teaching you how to live as befits a child of God. Now that you are older, you can profess for yourselves the same faith and reject sin for yourselves. Today you hold your own first communion candle that has been lit from the Paschal candle, the candle from which your parents lit your baptismal candle. And so now I ask you, children, do you reject the evil spirit and all his works and all his empty promises? Do you believe in God the Father Almighty and in Jesus, his only Son, and in the Holy Spirit? Do you believe in the Holy Catholic Church, in the communion of saints, and in the resurrection of the body and everlasting life? Dear children, at this solemn time of your first Holy Communion, I ask you to also make promises to the Lord Jesus. And so, do you promise to always profess the holy faith and always to practice your faith? Do you promise throughout your whole life to observe the Ten Commandments and all the teachings of the church? Do you promise to live in sanctifying grace as the children of God, which you are? Do you promise to participate in Sunday Mass regularly and go to the Sacrament of Confession at least once a year? Do you promise to grow deeper in your faith by participating regularly in your religion classes? Do you promise to stay away from any person, place, or thing that might lead you away from Christ and from His church and into sin? Now, communicants, please repeat after me. Holy Trinity, one God. Before you and in the presence of Mary, the Mother of God, and all the saints, our guardian angels, and everyone present in this church today, we solemnly renew the promises made at our baptism and add to them the promises we have made this day. Almighty God, grant us your grace that we may keep our promises, and with your help, come one day to eternal joy. Amen. All right, children, now, please gently and carefully extinguish your candles and return to your seats. Please stand. Now together let us profess our Catholic faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Now with confidence, let us present to the Lord our prayers of petition.
That the unity which comes from Christ, the true vine, may draw all Christians to his church. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the peace which God gives us may spread through nations involved in war, terrorism, or inner turmoil. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the hope which comes from the risen Lord may strengthen those who are pruned by suffering of body and mind. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the forgiving love of the Spirit within us may free us from fear and guilt. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the faithful departed may remain in Christ forever. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the children making their first Holy Communion in our parish this weekend. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, hear these humble prayers. Be attentive to so many other prayers we hold this day in the silence of our hearts. Give us the strength we need to serve you all our days joyfully. We ask this through Christ, who is our Lord, forever and ever. Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours might be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy,
indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit. You give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Stanislaus Kostka, Saint Helena, and with all of the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Alan, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassionate, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom, that we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
strengthen, O Savior of my soul. Bless my vision blindly, I turn from my true goal. Then let Amen.
Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord. Please be seated for announcements. A rosary walk will take place in our parish this Sunday immediately after this Mass, departing from the front steps of the church. Tomorrow is the feast day of Mary, Queen of Poland. Mass will be offered at 7 o'clock. During that Mass, the annual May crowning will take place. Friday of this week is the first Friday of the month. The Blessed Sacrament will be exposed for adoration on Friday morning from 9 o'clock until 6:30, when the benediction takes place, followed by Mass. Please do keep in mind that the parish offices are now closed on Wednesdays. On behalf of the entire parish, I want to express my personal best wishes, congratulations, and personal blessing to these three first communicants that we have with us today. Small crowd, but nevertheless, as long as there is some kind of lifeblood going through the veins, the plant is healthy, or at least not dead. So, to Sonia Francesca Glodowski, congratulations. Alberto Osmar Sanchez, congratulations. Ophelia Lynn Ruth Stewart, congratulations to all of you and to your families. May this be a blessed day for you. May it be the beginning of something, not a one-time affair, but the beginning of a long-term relationship with the Eucharistic Lord Jesus Christ. Please stand for the final blessing. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace.
Now pray to God, O virgin.